guys, it's Bailey from Making Up the Midwest, and I am back with a review of the new CoverGirl Outlast Stay Fabulous 3-in-1 Foundation. It's kind of been a buzz here on YouTube. I feel like lots of reviews of this have popped up recently. So I was at CVS, and I thought I would go ahead and pick it up and give it a go since I'm currently on a personal mission to try all the buzzworthy foundations out there. So I did. I have tried it, and I thought I would share my thoughts with you. So let's get started. First off, I am in the shade Creamy Natural. That's the shade that I've been using and I am currently wearing. The reason it's called 3-in-1 is because it's supposed to have the lasting power of a primer, coverage of a concealer, and blendability of a foundation, and as well as be shine free. That's not part of the three, it just says that at the bottom here. So that is what this foundation kind of touts, is, I guess to me, coverage and staying power is what all that says to me, and obviously act like a foundation, but to have the coverage or concealer, staying power with the primer, all that, whatever. It also has an SPF of 20, if you are curious. I personally always put SPF on underneath my foundation just because, you know, the way you buff and blend foundation in, it's such a thin layer that I just don't trust it. I don't trust that it's enough SPF for me throughout the day. So if it means anything to you, it has SPF 20. So to apply this today, I squirted a pump because it is a pump applicator. I squirted a pump of that onto the IT Cosmetics, I think this is called the Heavenly Luxe Foundation something brush. I'll put it in the bottom bar. It's what I've been using for my foundation for the past few weeks, so naturally I just kind of grabbed for this. I put it directly on the brush and then I dabbed it on my face and just started going to town with blending. First off, I noticed that it was not super thick, but not as thin as, say, like Revlon's Nearly Naked. In fact, I would compare it to another CoverGirl foundation that I've obviously used and loved, and that's the True Blend. So if anyone is familiar with that, I'd say it's comparable to something like that. So about a pump and a half of this, for me, created something that I would say sits solidly in the medium coverage area. It definitely wasn't light, but I could still see minor, imperfections or natural beauty features like freckles, discoloration, kind of like that. So I thought that was interesting because it does claim to have the coverage of a concealer. I thought I'd go ahead and give it an extra thin layer on areas like my cheeks and in my under eye area and on blemishes that I have on my chin and some on my forehead. So, after that I did notice that it covered up blemishes pretty well. Now, not raised kind of, fresh blemishes, that's disgusting, but it's the truth. That is obviously going to have a texture difference and therefore be more noticeable, but I did notice that on kind of bumps and, unopen, things like that, it laid pretty smoothly and it did a decent job of concealing it. Even still though, with an extra layer, I found that what I consider to be not a whole lot of pigmentation in my under eye area was still a little noticeable. So in that sense, I wouldn't say it has the coverage of a concealer. The blemishes, it was good, I thought, but not necessarily in the under eye area. I found myself having to go back in afterwards with a concealer to really get things as, flawless as I typically like them, I guess. So because this actually claims to be shine-free, I feel like I should comment on the finish that it does give. Obviously, it's not shiny, but I wouldn't call it completely matte. If I had to put a name to it, I'd say soft matte, because I don't think it's necessarily satin either. So I think it would be very flattering for those that have oily skin, combination skin like myself, more mature skin, because I think that's a finish that generally tends to flatter tiny or fine lines and wrinkles. As far as how it feels on, it's very light. I wouldn't, even on the areas where I layered on my cheeks and under eyes and forehead, stuff like that, it doesn't feel cakey or heavy or like just something sitting on your skin, nothing like that at all, which is great. And in terms of wear, because it does claim to have the lasting power of a primer, I think it's stellar. I looked, especially after I had kind of a rough experience with Benefit's Oxygen, that foundation I recently reviewed on the blog, and I was so disappointed with the wearing power. So it was kind of nice to start wearing this and find that it lasted all throughout the day. I could, start my day off with the makeup and I looked in the mirror at the end of the day and I had blush and bronzer, because I guess having that experience made me appreciate the a foundation that has really good staying power, because it just did not last with that. And I found that with this, you know, blush is still there, contour is still there, concealer is still there, which was great. And so I'll flash an after picture, if I haven't already, up so you can see kind of the before and after and see exactly what the wear is kind of like. I didn't notice it getting super shiny throughout the day, kind of like if you, again, if you know what the True Blend is like. This, I noticed, got a little bit dewier throughout the day, not so much with this. I think this developed into more of a true satin finish, but it didn't get greasy, oily, shiny, and that's from someone with combination skin. Now that the weather is the weather's warming up, but I mean, 30 is warm here. So I say it's getting warmer and I haven't noticed shine, but take it how you will for 30 degree weather. I think the last comment I want to make is about the packaging, and that is because I took for granted how much I liked having a pump dispenser. I've recently been using they're both Revlon. It's the Nearly Naked and the Color Stay Whipped, and for as much as I like them, I like the finish, I like the wear, overall great foundations, I don't like that they, I have to put my fingers, I have to physically touch them with fingers or something else to get them out of the packaging. To me, that is not as sanitary as I'd like it to be, and even though it's your own fingers day after day, it just, as someone who has obviously quite a few foundations, I feel rushed, you know, once I put my fingers in there and I know bacteria could be in there and grow and breed and all that nastiness, I feel the urge to then keep using that product up until it's gone. Otherwise it'll sit there, I'll forget about it, and then by the time I come back to it, it's gone. I mean, it's bad. I shouldn't be using it anymore because, you know, it's got nastiness in it. So I do like a product that has a pump, and this is something that has made me reappreciate it. So for those of you who like pump dispensers, bonus. Alright, I think that is all I had to say about the new CoverGirl 3-in-1 foundation, so I'll just finish with some final thoughts. I would recommend this to a lot of people. Like I said before, oily combination, mature skin, what is this, not mature skin? I don't know. In terms of dry skin, I didn't notice it being terribly drying, like say, maybe Maybelline's Age Rewind, that might be a little more drying, I think. I didn't notice that with this at all. It's not going to be super moisturizing though, so if you do have dry skin or very dry skin, you will have to rely on like a moisturizer underneath this, but I didn't notice it getting crepey or anything like that in the dry patches that I have as a combination skin kind of girl. You know, I didn't notice it getting flaky, cakey, dry, any of that kind of stuff. So I think this has such versatility, and it really does stay on. I don't know that I would say it has the coverage of a concealer, but the truth is that I am so in my routine of concealing that I don't think I would ever expect a foundation to do that anyway. So I guess it doesn't deliver on that claim, but I'm not too heartbroken over it. What else? It's just an overall good foundation. I think that is how I will conclude this video. So thank you so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed a review, one more review out there of this foundation, and I will see you in my next video. Oh, don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. I'll see you in my next video. Bye!